Students, today in our class we are going to study about the causes of conflict. And let's start our class. The first cause or the reason for conflict is individual differences. As we know, no men are alike in their nature, attitude, ideals, opinions and interest. These differences lead them to some or the other sort of conflict to fulfill their individual interest. Because of these differences, they fail to accommodate or adjust themselves with each other. Our thoughts are different, sometimes our opinion are different from others. So it was one of the reason or cause for conflict. The next cause for conflict is cultural differences. Culture differs from society to society, as we know, and also group to group. These differences sometimes cause tension and lead to conflict. The religious differences have often led to wars and other type of this tension. It creates tension in history. We can recall our past. In India, often communal conflicts broke out, which are the result of religious differences. So cultural difference is one of the cause for conflict. The next is a clash of interest. The next cause is clash of interest. The interests of different people or group occasionally clash. For example, the interest of the works clash with those of the employers, which leads to conflict in the form of strike, bond. In industries or in factory, we can saw that. So the clash of interest sometimes it became one of the cause for conflict. The next is social change. All parts of society do not change with the same speed. This causes lag or culture lag, we can say, in the parts which make cause of generations in the results of such social changes. So social changes become one of the reason or cause for conflict. So these are the causes for conflict. I hope you understand. Thanks for listening.